What's most important to you in buying windows, siding, or doors? Is it energy savings, cost, quality, or warranty? Window World offers it all by searching Window World today.
Hello and welcome into the WHKY News for Friday, June 21. Ralph Mangum with you. Be sure to watch the WHKY News every weekday over the air on Channel 14.2 and on Compass Cable in Burke County on Channel 142. The news is also posted on our website and on YouTube. In today's top stories, authorities are looking for a suspect in a fatal hit-and-run accident. WHKY's Ariana Mack has more.
The North Carolina State Highway Patrol is investigating a fatal hit and run in Lincoln County. The deceased is 23-year-old Jacob Michael Bentley of Lincolnton. The accident occurred at about 8:40 last night, June 20th, on Business 321 near Summer Row Road. A Ford Taurus was northbound on Business 321 when the driver crossed the center line. The Ford collided with a southbound 2003 Mitsubishi Montero driven by Mr. Bentley. After the initial collision, Mr. Bentley lost control and drove off the road. The Mitsubishi overturned, ejecting Mr. Bentley from the vehicle. He was not wearing a seatbelt. Mr. Bentley was critically injured and was transported by medical helicopter to Atrium Health Carolina's Medical Center in Charlotte, where he passed away. The driver of the Taurus fled the scene after the collision. The suspect vehicle is believed to be a silver or tan four-door Ford Taurus with a temporary registration plate. The Taurus is missing its left front headlight assembly. The images accompanying this story are examples of the suspect's vehicle. Anyone with any information regarding this accident should contact Highway Patrol. The investigation is continuing. Stay tuned to WHKY.com for updates. I'm Ariana Mack for WHKY.
Thank you, Ariana, and our condolences to Mr. Bentley's family and loved ones. Hickory police are investigating an armed robbery at an apartment on Valley Arbors Drive in Hickory yesterday. The incident occurred at about 6:15 p.m. Thursday. The victim is a 36-year-old male from Statesville. A Michael Kors bag containing $15,000 cash was taken. The bag was recovered, however, the cash was not. The suspect was armed with a handgun, according to police reports. It's not clear at this time if shots were fired or if anyone was injured. As of Friday afternoon, no charges had been filed. The investigation is ongoing. With details on an arrest in a Caldwell County drug case, here's WHKY's Rob Eastwood.
The suspect in this case faces multiple felony drug charges and is also charged with multiple counts of violating probation. He was arrested after police responded to a business here in Caldwell County. The suspect was reportedly in a vehicle at that business. A search resulted in the discovery of methamphetamine and fentanyl. The suspect was placed in jail under more than $150,000 bond. Multiple court dates were scheduled. 34-year-old Alvin Lawrence Hames of Lenoir was arrested Tuesday by Caldwell County Sheriff's officers. He's charged with two felony counts apiece of trafficking in methamphetamine and fentanyl, along with two felony counts of possession with intent to sell and deliver Schedule II controlled substance. Hames is also charged with several counts of felony probation violation. At approximately 3 p.m. Tuesday, Hames was seen sitting in a vehicle at a convenience store in Hudson. Detectives arrested Hames on the probation violation warrants, then searched the vehicle. Detectives reportedly found approximately 29 grams of methamphetamine and 6 grams of fentanyl under Hames' seat. The drugs seized during the investigation have a total street value of $7,785, according to North Carolina State Drug Guidelines. Hames is currently on probation for possession of a stolen vehicle and possession of a firearm by a convicted felon. Those convictions were in 2022 and 2023 in Caldwell County. Following the arrest, Hames was placed in the Caldwell County Detention Center in Lenoir under a $170,000 bond. A Friday district court date was scheduled. A Superior Court appearance is scheduled for August 5th. Reporting from Caldwell County for WHKY News, I'm Rob Eastwood.
Thank you, Rob. Up next, Ariana, Rob, and I have the Friday Crime Report. Ariana has more information on the arrest of a Granite Falls woman that was first reported yesterday here on WHKY. I have one more from Caldwell, and then Rob has several Burke County arrests to tell you about. In local sports today, Jason Savage has American Legion baseball, Crawdads baseball, and some tennis news from Appalachian State. In community focus, Ariana has the details on a new summer food assistance program for kids. And Rob reports as the NCDOT is looking for public input on the department's long-range capital plan. Mostly sunny and hot today with a high almost reaching 90. We're expecting highs in the low 90s through the weekend and on into the middle of next week. Upper 80s after that, with the best chances of rain coming next Wednesday and Thursday. You can always find an up-to-date forecast at WHKY.com whenever you need it. I'm Ralph Mangum. You are watching the WHKY News.